Hello friends, we are meeting after a long time and today we are going to learn fuzzy logic. This topic is also very important for our NEET examination as it will help you to score up to 6 to 8 marks. And we are not going to learn into too much depth, but definitely we'll see whatever is important for our examination. And in today's session, we are going to see what is mean by fuzzy logic, what are the applications and what are the properties. So let's see what is fuzzy logic. This term is first of all discovered by the famous author, or we can say the famous philosopher, that is Lofty Azadeh, in 1965 in his paper Fuzzy Set. Okay. So this term is basically made up of two words, that is fuzzy and logic. So what is mean by this logic? So this logic word we are also using in our everyday life. For example, is there any logic behind this? It means we are trying to get the reason behind the things. So in simple words, we can say that logic means reason and fuzzy logic is logic of reasoning. Okay. So let's see fuzzy logic. And before looking at the concept of fuzzy logic, we must have to clear what is mean by traditional logic. So first of all, we'll see what is traditional logic. So what is traditional logic? It is also known as binary logic or crisp logic. And here the word itself gives us idea. Binary means by. It means it is a two valued logic. So what are these two values? Okay. So these two values are nothing but true or false, yes or no, one or zero. So the possible answer for my any question is only two. That is, either it is a true or false, yes or no, one or zero. For example, switch. If there is no light in the room, we switch on the button. If there is a light in the room, we switch off the button. It means there are only two possibilities. Okay? So the boundary of my answer is very strict for this binary logic. Then we'll move to the fuzzy logic. So what is this fuzzy logic? Here, this fuzzy logic is also known as membership logic. Membership logic, okay, or multi-valued logic. Why it is multi-valued logic? Okay, so we'll see the meaning. The meaning of fuzzy word means vague, it is imprecise, or which is not accurate, means fuzzy. For example, if I'll take a example that one person is going from road and I'm in a gallery and I'm looking at that person, I'm saying that how fat he is, or he is so fat. But here my answer or my reaction is very vague. Vague means what? Fat means how much fat. That is, I don't know the exact weight of that person, but just looking at that person, I'm making a statement that he is a fat. So this fat term is a fuzzy term, okay? Because this fat, suppose his weight is 85 kg. So how I can decide that? Maybe for this fatness, I have a values from 80 to 90 kg. For very fat person, if I say, if it is 90 and above and up to 110, then I say very fat. Okay. So here there is no only single value, there are multiple values which describes my term fat. So here there is a no restriction of like this binary logic. So this is a term fuzzy. And we'll see one more example to describe or distinguish between this binary logic and fuzzy logic. You are my audience, and if I'll ask you the question, are you married? Then maybe someone will say yes, someone will say no. So here the probable answer set for my question is only yes and no. So this is my traditional. But now I'm going to ask you one question, and of course you can laugh for this. If I'll ask you the funny question that, are you really happy in your married life? Then someone will say, yes, I'm happy, very, very happy, extremely happy, little happy, okay, okay. So we'll get many answers for this. It means what is happening, the extreme end of my answer is one, that is true, or yes, I'm happy in my married life, and the other extreme end is false. That is, no, I'm not happy, Or if someone is saying, I'm little happy, I'm very happy, then there may be the value which lies between my yes and no or 0 and 1. It means for this fuzzy logic, we have the value 0 which gives us no, it is strictly not. 1 says yes, it is strictly yes, and 1 value which lies between 0 and 1. Okay, so it is not the real member, but it is what? Partial member, which gives us the truth value of your member. Okay, so this is nothing but the introduction part of fuzzy logic. Now we'll see on actual ground how this fuzzy logic works. Okay, for example, we have a set called as 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10. It is a set of first 10 natural numbers. From this set, I'll create a two set. One is called as A set, which is my binary set. And in this set, if I write 1, 3, 5, 8. By looking at this set, I can clearly say that 1 is a member of my set A, 2 is not a member, 3 is a member, 4 is not a member, 5 is a member, and so on. So this is very strict. Either it is a member or either it is not a member. But from this set, again I create a different set, that is now fuzzy set, that is A. And to indicate that it is my fuzzy set, I'm going to use a one-tailed operator, which indicates that it is my fuzzy set. And in this set, I'll write like this, 1 upon 1 plus 1 upon 2 plus 0.5 upon 3 plus 0.3 upon 4 plus 0 upon 5 plus 0.6 upon 6 plus 0.9 upon 7 plus etc. up to 1 upon 10. Okay? Now here, why I have written like this? Actually, this is a Zadar's notation to indicate that it is my fuzzy set. And here, this divider or this horizontal line is not a divider. It is just to differentiate between your member and membership value. In a numerator, we have written the membership value. It contains, and the denominator is member. So here, 1 is a member of my set, and this 1 is a membership value of this member. Here this plus is not a summation. It indicates, or it is used to indicate, the separation between your members. So here 1 is a member having the membership value 1, that is, it is a full member of my fuzzy set. 2 is also the full member as it is having the truth value 1. 3 is a partial member of my set having a truth value 0.5. 4 is a partial member having a 0.3. 5 is not a member because the value is 0. We can also skip this, but to understand, we have written here that value also. 6 is a partial member, 7 is a partial member, and 10 is a full member. Okay? So in this way, we can represent our fuzzy set. So for this, to understand what is fuzzy set, this is okay, and this is introduction. Now we'll see the applications. Actually, fuzzy logic is a very popular technology, and nowadays it is used everywhere. For example, in medical science, it is used, chemical industry, business, aeroscience, everywhere. So in home appliances also. So I'll just elaborate one example where we are using fuzzy logic. That is washing machine. If you have a fully automated washing machine, then you might have seen the word fuzzy on your washing machine. What it means that your machine has to take decision that how much water intake it has to take, what should be the proportion of washing powder, how much time it has to spin your clothes, and then what is the dirtiness, what is the fabric of your clothes. To decide all this, your machine is going to decide based on the size of your clothes and dirtiness of your clothes. But the question is that each and every time the size of clothes is not fixed. First time, suppose this is my machine, and here I'll say the 5, 10, 15, 20, and 25. Suppose up to this I can fit the 5 clothes. If there are 5 flows and 13 ends, based on this, it is going to decide the intake of water, the maybe the temperature of your water also. If I'll put the flows up to this, then there is a different value for this, there is a different value. It means the value of my flows is not fixed. So to decide all this, we are using here the concept called fuzzy. Okay. So this is a short and very common example which we are also using in our house. So these are the various applications. Now we'll see the properties. There are 10 properties. These properties we have already learned somewhere in electronics or maybe in mathematics also. So what are these 10 properties? These all 10 properties are supported by traditional set. So what are these? The first one is commutative, associativity, distributivity, idempotency, identity, transitivity, involution, De Morgan's law, law of excluded middle, law of contradiction. Now here, how to recall these properties? So here I'll give you one short notations to recall these properties. The first three properties, that is commutative, associativity and distributivity, to recall this we'll use a word CAD, where C stands for commutativity, A for associativity and D for distributivity. Then we'll recall next three properties, that is called as IIT, where I stands for idempotency. Idempotency means A union A is equals to A, A intersection A is equals to A. Identity, A union phi is equals to A, A intersection phi equals to phi, A intersection X. Here this X is nothing but the universe set or universe of discourse. It is also called as universe of discourse, is equals to A, A union X is equals to X. And the next one is transitivity. So these three terms will recall it as a IIT. And here the next two terms, that is ID. So ID, I for involution and D for De Morgan's law. And the last two properties will recall as a L square. But remember that all these 10 properties are supported by classical set. But fuzzy set does not support law of excluded middle, that is this is not equivalent. And law of contradiction, that is this is also not equivalent. So fuzzy logic supports only first 8 properties and the last two properties are not supported by fuzzy logic. So in exam they might ask you the question, which properties are not supported by fuzzy logic, and this question already asked in the set examination. So you can just note down these, and these are very easy. Here simply like in electronics we write A plus B bar is equals to A bar dot B bar. Instead of here plus and dot, we are just using the union and intersection. Okay, so these are the properties. Thank you so much for watching my video, and we'll see next lecture for proper operations on fuzzy set and how to solve the examples on the fuzzy set. Okay, thank you so much.